solid work on the show, by the way.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah, very grounded. It's fun to work on. Yeah, very grounded, very natural, and yeah, just enjoyable. Like you fit in that world,
which
is wonderful.
That's very nice to hear. I appreciate that.
Yeah. Kudos to the casting department on that show as well.
Yeah, David Rappaport. Love him.
Are you serious?
I am very serious.
Love David.
The CW King.
Right?
Literally.
Do you know how many times I've been pinned and how many producer sessions I have?
Thousands.
Oh my gosh. He's so nice. I love that whole office.
I love that office. Can I say another reason I love that office?
Yeah.
I don't know how your experiences have been, but when I go to that office, I very rarely ever have to wait. Like I go in and there's usually like one person before me.
Oh, do you go in at your actual time?
I mean, we keep it cute. I go around.
Okay.
It depends on like, if I have like a lot of auditions that day, I try to hit like a time frame kind of thing.
Right.
But like, I've never waited there for like 30 minutes.
Wow.
Like, I feel like they're always on it. You know how some casting will be like, we start at 11, but then they won't start till 11:30. Mm-hmm. So they wait till everyone gets there and they can just, he doesn't do that, which I love.
What I love about that office, they're smiling.
Yeah, they're always great, and they always give a redirect, which I love.
Mm-hmm.
Love that.
I like seeing people, especially casting, smiling in the corner of my eye when I'm performing for the producers or whatever, because then it just makes me feel good as the actor.
It's like, okay, someone here is rooting for me, besides me.
Right, somebody is.
Yeah.
And I just, I really appreciate them because they get it from our perspective as well. Good readers too, which you don't always get as in the casting department field. And I think, I don't know how in your experience is, I think casting directors are also realizing that. Like, oh, we need to be good readers or have somebody come in.
Or like in it.
Yeah.
Like eye contact, you know, stuff like that.
Very important.
Yeah, very, very. Like, there's nothing like doing an emotional scene and you're just looking at someone's forehead. And you're like,
you're right. I'll tell you what I did once. It was kind of a ballsy move and it worked out.
At David Rappaport or in general?
Oh, in general. I'm not going to tell you.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Don't do that. Don't do that. Yeah.
But it was a really intense scene.
Okay.
And the reader, she didn't mean this in any kind of disrespectful way, but she was just making sure, like, she had the right line
like
coming up.
Like your cues.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And it was really intense, and I was in the moment, and she wasn't looking up, and I said, look at me. And it wasn't in the script. And it was, like, in the character. You know what I mean? It was, like, in the moment.
Right.
And she goes, and I continued at it. But it was great, because we actually, like, had this
connection.
A connection. And I was like, cool, thank you so much, thanks. And everyone was like, cool, thank you. So it was, like, in the moment, but I was like,
stuff like that could be misinterpreted. Yeah, true. Yeah.
It's a risk, but I feel as actors, why not, man?
Yeah. What do you have to lose? Like, take a risk.
You feel
improv.
Yeah.
Do a button. You know what I mean?
You feel like you're more confident in the rooms nowadays?
Mm-hmm.
You're taking more risks?
Yeah. I've been in LA 7 years, and I feel like you hear all these rules, like, don't improv, don't do this, don't do that. But everyone's different and every experience is different. Like you may say something that'll make them go, that's actually what we want, even though it's not in the script.
Yeah.
And if they don't want you to do anything off the cuff, they'll just tell you. Like, can you do that again? But really no improv. The writers aren't into that.
Yeah.
You know, like I feel like you're allowed to take risks.